I don't fucking think so. Oh, fucking hell. Nice and slow. Not gonna get too deep, right? You know, worried 25% ill. Go on, Ermintrude. Come on, girl. It's like I've not passed, innit? Fucking hell. Yeah! Yes, we took off then. Better with that fucking camera there then. Let's hope weather holds off. This is Phil's bin. Nice to be out. Fucking doing? Fucking taxi drivers. They're supposed to be professional, but they're so fucking lazy. So technically, he warrant yellow box, so it worries right away, I guess. Because it's first we're not booked at us right away. in there.
Thank you.
doing in no rush. Get there when we get there and just enjoy the ride. No matter about getting up to top speed, we ain't gonna fucking do it. Not about the way that I'm carrying. We may catch it, about kills that are carried. Right over its maximum carry weight, that's for sure. Maximum carry weight, 118 kilos. So I'm 110, we catch it much weight, fucking 803 kilos. It's not for us.
One thing about a big bike, it just squirt past traffic. But on a 125, you're pretty much fucked. You just don't have the power to overtake. So, best thing to do is just to sit back and chill. If you have to plan your journey and allow for more time, because you've got to let bike rest. It's not designed to do all these miles in one shot. It's only designed to do about a 10-20 mile commuter run, and that's about it. So when you're doing hundreds of miles in one shot, it's always best to stop. I always do it around every 50 miles. I'll stop and I'll stretch my legs and I'll have a thing in a brew or something. Just let bike have a rest, otherwise you're just going to fucking knack in your main crank bearing. But other than that, so yeah, maintenance is key. You've got to maintain it. Especially on these bikes that are made out of Chinese here. About Yorkshire, there's loads of good bikery, there's absolutely loads of them. Maybe you go to across North Yorkshire Moors to Whitby and Scarborough and Burlington, or coming up into Dales and up to Chit Lake, or you can go up the other way, you go through Bentham and all that, or to Markham. Who knows where you'd want to go to Blackburn? Oh, Markham, that is. After they go to Whitby, or fucking. Just a shame what Northern Rail did at Whitby about whistle-stop cafe. Stopping bikes fucking parking in car park. That was brilliant there. Park up, have a bacon butty and a brew. I don't know why they won't even let you do pay and display. I don't think they do. I mean, I could display when I've got this bag in here. But I have that having. I could display it there so it won't get wet. Musical bastard. I mean, that's going to kill Whistle Stop Cafe, is that? Well, Whistle Stop Series in Whitby. Wonder how we're getting on. I'll try and rush in, because if I get in front of him, I'm only going to slow him down when we go over Buxton Pike. I can't be lucky if I get above 25, 30 miles an hour going over there. But I'm only going to slow him down, and it's just not worth all fucking aggro. So just take your time and enjoy it. Thank you. kills me. Climbing up that, kills the crab. Not looking all round, but I can't get up round that. Certainly ain't a spot for fat knackers like me. It's a perfect little one, but it's the one that's climbing up that. Throw you off if you get that wrong. Thing here, you've got to be careful, you've got eyeballs, you can't see out in the car because it's warm, so you don't know if out's coming. I mean, it's not so bad on a bike, you settle before you can see, and sometimes passing places get a little bit narrow, so yeah, you've got to be a bit careful.
could go and star button. Star button. I've got a rusty star on my bottom. The old rusty sheriff's badge. He's running like a champ now. Although I have put a CR7 spark plug in, CR7 NGK or whatever it is, rather than standard CR6. If it has an higher temperature rating, higher resistance, it seems to be a bit better for it. Slightly advanced, but at least it's getting up to 60 now. Getting way better on hills. Not that it's carried down as much. America might have big country and tall mountains, which I'm quite jealous of. But it's just as fucking beautiful here in England. But I'd love to do America. Especially Trans-America Trail. Well, what inspired me were with a channel called Some Guy Rides. An easy Trans-America Trail on an Honda CT 125. That's what inspired me to do this. Although I have been riding bikes on and off since I was fucking 15. I've been banned twice on them in my younger years when I was a pup. Just never got out of passing my test, and now I've got over 30 years of driving experience. It's the theory test that's putting me off. This star button, because I can see potential hazards happening before even fucking whoever the programmer was. So I'm never saying it's clicking, you're clicking randomly, are you clicking to whoever? And it's like, no, because I see the potential hazard, but whoever did programming I've seen. So I've got to change that mindset altogether, as if I don't know no. Well, obviously when you've been driving and riding all sorts of vehicles over 30 odd years, it's pretty hard to do. But but I am going to bite bullet and do it. You're still right there, Ermintrude, when I pass my test. Fucking course I will. I fucking love this bike. So comfy. Now, my little K8-125, which you haven't really seen me on because it's stripped down, but I'm restoring. It feels a smaller bike and you feel top heavy. But this one, it's planted. It feels like a bigger bike. I mean, I can do 50, 60 miles. Like it says, across country back there, I did 270 miles. I wouldn't have been able to do that on the K8, but mind you, that's a little two-stroke. Anyway, you all wanted commentary. There's your fucking commentary. Although, I'm not a really big talker. I speak when I'm spoken to, especially when I'm driving. I concentrate so much on road, you'll get a year or a no out of me. There's one thing I love enjoying, biggest passion in life, is driving, or riding. So, I'm good at it, it's what I do. One of the best things about a 125, you can't rush, and so because you can't rush, you just get to see more. Just way more relaxed, rather than treading needles from apex to apex on a bigger bike. You can just meander on a 125. To know about running costs. Well, obviously you've got your price of your MOT and your vehicle excise duty, as it's called now, which is vehicle excise duty at Buxton. We're at Buxton now, I've got to tell you. It's about 26 quid per year. Your MOT is your MOT, which is what, about 30 quid per year. Insurance, for me and Gobby, to be honest, a learner, it's about £110 per year, so 200 quid per year to run bike. And petrol, well, it goes about 120 miles a gallon, and that's with me on, and that's its max carry weight. So if you're someone as skinny as Gobby, you've got to do more. It has a 2-gallon tank, so that gives you a range of about 240 miles. He knows where he's going. We ain't going to follow him, but he's just going to do his own thing. What the comfortable at.
Good job, now we're coming up the way. That was a bit tight. Go on, girl. Go on. That's your little beauty. Now, I'm down that fucking green lane there. I'm going to do that one there. by the limbs are up.
taking me this way when I could have gone that way. When we get to home, we'll stop there and have a big or a drink. Thank you.
fucking run up there, it's got fucking deck gauges, look how light water is. Fucking hell. Stop here and have a quick ciggy. Have a ciggy break, let Ermintrude. Have a chill out for a bit. And have a ciggy. Why not? Look how fucking grand it is. Hey. Geronimo. Next stop, Britannia Lane. Hello. Getting gear first, it is helping it. Thank you.
going to Mucker. You know, we're in 25% ill. Go on, Ermintrude. Come on, girl. Girl, we can do it. Come on. Come on, girl. Oh, what a trooper. around, isn't it? Mint saucy bastard, fuck off over there. Fuck you know. Just as well he can't go tear arsing around, it's too nice, isn't it? Why the fuck would you want to? I still feel guilty about saying I won't care if we were right or not. I've got a bag full of tools if I stuck for them. But you never know, do you? Question is, can a little AJS 125 scrambler make it all the way to the Cat and Fiddle Inn? Well, we're not there yet, but so far, fingers crossed.
tail down yonder.
Thank you.
sure I didn't get a fucking bus through there. Canhill, 4 miles. My car's not passing it. Fucking hell. Plenty well's been dropped there. Come on, Ermintrude. We can do it. Thank you. Come on. Come on.
You can do it. You can do it.
Yeah. busy, are we here? It looks like it, looking busy. Boys and girls, it was the highest pub, Britannia Lane.